Joe James, and I'm the lead nurse for dementia at Imperial. Well, one of the big issues for people, particularly if they've got dementia or any other cognitive problem when they're in hospital, is they find it very hard to occupy themselves. One of the things that really it impacts on is actually giving people a bit of purposeful occupation. So they get to either listen to music or watch films or watch film clips. Also, it gives staff the chance to engage with people. It also gives us a chance to find ways of actually finding out about people, who they are, what their likes are, and sharing that with other people. And so it's a real sort of engagement tool. We're seeing far better engagement with our patients. We're also seeing staff wanting to use it. And so we're actually getting staff ringing up and saying, is there one around that we can use? What we started doing as well is we started using it as part of our decision process around, you know, getting a one-to-one to look after someone with agitation or distress. So we actually now will ask the staff if they've engaged someone using the software to see if we can actually, you know, get them occupied and de-escalate the problem that way. We have a very strong ethos at Imperial around supporting carers and family to actually sort of work in partnership with them, and for them to come in and be on the wards and a part of the sort of, you know, the healing environment. And so we quite often will teach families and engage them in actually using the software to, you know, to work with someone. We also are just beginning around doing the life story work, and with the life story work, the families can actually bring in photographs, or they can actually sort of ping them over from home, and that can be used to make a sort of book about that person, who they are, and, you know, their history, and that's really, really important when you're caring for someone. People with dementia in hospital are often reluctant to eat and drink, and we have lots of problems around persuading them. So we started doing these social eating events where we put a table in the middle of the ward, everybody bakes cakes, and we use the software in that situation to play music, but to do quizzes. So we do group quizzes, and it's about everybody doing something together, so you get a sense of community, sense of being in a sort of social environment rather than a clinical one.
So I'm Katie, I'm the ward manager at Albert Ward at St Mary's Hospital, Imperial College Healthcare Trust, and I work on a bedded unit, 28 beds. A lot of those patients have had orthopaedic surgery and then come down to our step down unit to then be discharged home. So a lot of our patients have dementia and quite complex needs. It was very difficult. When I first came here, we didn't have the software. We had music, and apart from that, there wasn't a lot else. We would have quite high falls risks of patients that are just very agitated, not being stimulated throughout the day, and then at night time would just want to get up, get out of bed, find someone that they knew, wanted to go home, really disorientated. We've been trying to work on stimulating patients during the day, trying to get their sleep-awake cycle correct. Our falls have reduced. And there was actually a period of time, it was about 3 weeks, 2 or 3 weeks, where our system didn't work, and we saw a massive increase in our falls. So it was really, really alarming, actually, what a difference it is making. We're trying to do a quality improvement project, which we are using My Life as the main theme behind that, to try and get groups of patients together, find a common ground, get them involved in an activity or a music or a sing-along or playing bingo, just something that engages everybody, brings them together, and then they can have a meal. We've also used it with physiotherapy sessions, getting the patients doing exercises. It's really, really vital that we do everything we can to get them moving, because it will determine their destination. You know, we could prevent people going to a nursing home. I found it really alarming that there are a lot of patients that wouldn't really communicate, quite mute with their dementia. And as soon as you put music on, it just takes them back, and they will talk for hours about their dancing days and their youth and where they used to go and who they met and meeting their husbands. And so that just brings on a whole new conversation, which is great to get to know the patient that you're looking after. It's made such a difference. We've actually won a Make the Difference award. We got nominated by our bosses, our management, just because it has transformed the way that we deliver our nursing care to patients with dementia. There's proof around it, shortening length of stay, because we're just engaging people a lot quicker, helping with delirium, getting people back on their feet, and so that we can get them out of hospital.